Welcome to another Pitkin County Healthy Rivers construction update. We wanted to share with you the latest exciting development in this project. We're beginning to install the structures, the actual structures, that will create the play waves. And this is very important to the success of this project. For Pitkin County to be able to use the recreational in-channel diversion as a tool to keep water in the Roaring Fork River, water must flow between two in-stream riced structures and serve a beneficial purpose while doing so. In this case, that benefit is recreation, surfing waves, and having fun. It's very important that the experience of these waves is fun and that lots of people use these features. In order to call water downstream in the future, the county will need to show the waves are providing this benefit. So what exactly goes into making one of these waves? The foundation of each wave structure consists of two large concrete wave blocks and a whole lot of very big boulders. Our project engineers have figured out the elevation and orientation for each of these wave blocks that is necessary to create optimal wave conditions. There are several stages to installing the wave blocks. First, a precast concrete footer is installed deep in the stream bed. Next, a concrete riser is added to the footer. The footer and riser are hollow when they're first installed. That makes them less heavy and safer and easier to place in the proper position. Once placed, they'll be filled with concrete and capped. It's the flow of water over the wave block caps that'll create the waves and the fun. We'll talk more about the caps when they're installed. Thanks for joining us today. We'll continue to share our progress as this in-stream work progresses. And if you'd like more information, go to our website, PictonCountyRivers.com.